We told you there are two unique things in the partnership. One is the partners pre-endal appropriation account, the other one is partners capital account. For partners capital account, there are two system of partners capital account. One is called fixed capital system. It is fixed capital system, fluctuating capital system. Otherwise, I can just imply that you know the system and all, we can proceed. But anyway, we like to recall such information. It is fixed capital system and fluctuating capital system. Under fixed capital system, the partnership firm will maintain two accounts, partners capital accounts and partners current account. Under fluctuating capital system, the partnership firm will maintain only one account called partners current account. I'm sorry, capital account. Under fixed capital system, the partnership firm will maintain partners capital account and partners current account. Under fluctuating capital system, the partnership firm will maintain only partners capital account. So what is this? Both will give same effect or different effects? Same things only. All things are accounted in both the system. It is not in one place this is accounted, another place it is not accounted. In both the cases, all transactions relating to the capital are accounted. Understood? So is it divided into two parts or everything in single account? That is the only difference between these two systems. All the increase and decrease to the partner's capital will be accounted. Whether it is accounted through two accounts or in a single account is the difference between fixed and fluctuating. You should be very clear with that. Understood? It is never that, sir, these transactions accounted here and these transactions never accounted here. It is not like that. All the transactions affecting the partner's capital will be accounted. So please respond, open your mouth. All the capital, all the transactions affecting the partner's will be accounted through this fixed capital system and? But only thing is, it is prepared in two accounts or single account. Understood? Under fixed capital system, we are preparing two accounts called partners capital account and partners current account. I'll tell you what. There is lot of difference between presenting a balance sheet like this. Balance sheet of the partnership firm. We have sundry assets, 100 lakhs. Sundry liability, 20 lakhs. Partners capital A, B, 50, 30, 80 lakhs. This is one balance sheet. Another balance sheet of the partnership firm. That is same partnership firm, same date balance sheet. Sundry assets, 100 lakhs. Sundry liability, 20 lakhs. Partners capital A, B, 10 lakh, 5 lakh, 15 lakhs. Partners current account A, B, 40, 25, 65. Both are same balance sheet or different balance sheet? Same balance sheet, correct? The first balance sheet does not communicate the real growth of a partnership firm. Now please understand, my dear, you are not there in the class, you are getting disturbed by some fun. Come back to the class, please. Yeah, you only. So we understand, listen, in the first balance sheet, this balance sheet doesn't convey the growth of a business or partnership firm, which is conveyed through the second balance sheet. Second balance sheet, a reader will understand that the partners brought a capital of partners have brought a, no dreams, my dear. Partners have brought a capital of, and it has grown from that to such an extent, to the extent of 65 lakhs, and now the present wealth is 80 lakhs, correct?
The growth is very much conveyed through the second balance sheet, which is not there in first balance sheet, because in first balance sheet, whether this 80 lakhs is profits or is it that you brought for 80 lakhs, we don't know. Correct? So second balance sheet will show that we have generated a profit of 65 lakhs or maybe much more than that, and still we could retain that 65 lakhs. Understood? So we are having an ability of earning this much profit and retaining such profit. If the profit is not going to generate further profits, then there won't be any point in retaining it. A business earns profit, whether it is to be distributed or retained depends upon whether that profit earned can it generate more profits. Suppose I had 100 rupees, everybody, and I got a profit of 10. I got a profit of 10. The next year, the 10 rupees what I earn, should I distribute or retain, depends upon whether this 10 if I put, can I get extra profit? That is the point, correct? If I put 110 and still if I am getting 10 rupees, then there is no point of retaining 10. But if this 10 also can generate 1 rupee profit, then there is some point in retaining, because outside the returns are only 5% or 6%, means in the business I am getting 10% return. Are you following? So please understand that. So thereby, this second balance sheet is more communicative and it provides a lot of information to the readers. Yes, sir. Understood? It shows the real growth of the business. Understood? Yes, sir. So what is that, sir? You didn't explain what is the system and all. Now let us understand. In a fixed capital system, the amount initially contributed by the partners alone will be recorded in this capital account. All other adjustments, generally adjustment means profit. The profits in various forms and amount already withdrawn will be adjusted through this account. Which account? Current account. Understood? But if it is a fluctuating capital system, if it is a? Then all the transaction, initially you brought 10 lakhs, later on profit this much, you have drawn this much, everything will be routed through this account, which is partners capital account. This is fluctuating capital system, this is fixed capital system. In this system, the initial contributed capital changes and every time it keep on changing, it is fluctuating. Correct? Here, the initially contributed capital will never change, will never fluctuate. Understood? Please respond. Yes, so it is going to be fixed forever, and that is what fixed capital system. Understood? Yes, so thereby it is not having any other advantage and all, because ultimately the current account is also money payable by business to partner. Capital account is also money payable by business to the partner. So otherwise there is no point of distinction between these two. Could you appreciate that? Yes, so this provides better information to the readers, and as the partnership firm itself, it's a good sign for showing this partner's capital and current account. Initially, on what amount this business was started, and maybe it could be started with 1 lakh. With 1 lakh, within 3 months, there is possibility you can earn even 3,000 lakhs, 300 crores. It is possible. It is happening in our country. Understood? With 1 lakh, so many crores people are earning within such a short span of time. No politics, eh? Now listen carefully. Let us proceed further. So we understand that it is having two system of capital. One is fixed capital system, the other one is? Under this fixed capital system, we are maintaining two accounts called partners capital account and partners current account. So the general format will be, so when you prepare this partners capital account, and partners current account, everybody. Now the partner initially bringing cash, so buy cash. Understood? This amount will be unaffected forever, it will be carried forward to the next year. Everybody, next year again this account, how it will be prepared now? Buy balance brought down, two balance carry down. Buy balance brought down, two balance carry down. Like that, it will not be touched at all. It will be simply brought down, carry down. Understood? Then why you prepare such account? We should be showing every year some account. Understood? Sir, why? It will be simply brought down from the previous year. It is carried forward to the next year with the same amounts. Understood? Any increase or decrease to the partner's capital? Sound bhayangara kammi irukku. Indha pasanga thoongiruvaanga illana.
హలో இல்லை காது கிழிய மாதிரி சொல்கிறோம்.
ஹலோ ஹலோ ஆ சமையல்
ஹலோ ப்ளீஸ் லிசன் கேன் யூ லிசன் தி இன்க்ரீஸ் ஆர் டிக்ரீஸ் டு த பார்ட்னர்ஸ் கேபிட்டல் பேலன்சஸ் will be routed through this account called current account. If you are giving profits to the partners, then it is by profit and loss account. Then partner withdrawing money, drawings. Correct? Whatever profit that we are giving, we have adequate time, my dear. Then and there I will give break. So don't see watch and all, first row only sitting and seeing. Seeing watch and showing this expression. Only 40 minutes over. Please listen. Profits will be distributed. The partnership chapter to take off, it requires little time. Once it is take off, it will be wonderful. There are lot of interesting parts in death of the partner, in admission, retirement. So the share of profit in various heads like commission, interest, salaries, all these things will be taken to current account. Drawings, interest on drawings will be debited and you will be arriving at the balance. And both the balance will be taken into balance sheet. Understood? In a fixed capital, in a fluctuating capital system, you contributed capital, profit will be added in the same account, drawings will be deducted, all adjustment in single account called partners capital account. Understood? That way we have two system of capital, fixed capital system. They are not going to test you, fixed capital system, fluctuating capital system, the examination. Very rare, sometimes very remotely it may be tested. But you should be certainly having awareness about this fixed and fluctuating capital system. You should know what they are actually, what is the basic difference, because when we take up dissolution of partnership firm, we apply something called Gardner versus Murray rules. In that we apply capital ratio. In that you should be having a clear distinction between the fixed capital system and, because if it is fixed capital system, I will apply a different ratio, and if it is fluctuating, I got a different ratio. Are you following? So like that, whatever we discuss have some impact subsequent topics that we will be discussing, the major topics. So don't think it's basics then I know, don't be seated. You should let us refresh ourselves into this basic knowledge. Understood? That way we have fixed capital system and fluctuating capital system. Understood? So what are the items that will come in the capital balance? What are the items that affects the capital? It is very simple. Profit, additional capital, drawings. Correct? Profit. That profit in different heads, that's all. It is not that, sir, profit only, yes, commission not there, salary not there, interest not there, please understand that. All these things are nothing but part of profit. So profits in different forms. Capital balance, profit in different forms, and then you will have additional capital sometimes. Drawings, interest on drawings. Could you appreciate that? Everybody. Now, if it is fixed capital system, all these adjustments will be routed through current account. Understood? A profit in different forms. Additional capital won't come here. I repeat. All adjustments should be routed through except additional capital. Understood? So, because the capital account should reveal how much capital contributed by the partners from their personal resources. Understood? So thereby additional capital, if it is there, will not come in current account. Understood? Everybody. All other items will come in current account. Are you following this? So thereby we'll be taking all the items in the partners current account except the initial capital contributed and additional. Drawings will come where? But if it is drawing of capital, it will come in capital account. If it is drawing of capital, then it will come in? Generally, drawing means it is drawing of
profits. That you should be knowing. Generally, drawing means it is only drawing of
profits.
But if it is specifically mentioned, no, no, I initially contributed 20 lakhs and those time you contributed only 5 lakhs. Now give my amount back. Understood? That way there could be specific transaction for withdrawing the capital. If it is mentioned in the question, that will come in the capital account. Understood? Otherwise, general term drawings is always drawing against profit. And it will come only in current account, not in capital account. Could you appreciate that? So these are all the things you should be knowing. There are two systems of capital. One is fixed capital system. The other one is fluctuating capital system. Understood? You know how to compute interest on partner's drawing, correct? You know how to compute interest on? We have already learned the average due date method and all, correct? Everybody. But usually, the partner withdraws some fixed amount every month beginning or every month mid or every month end. It is not create a transaction. It is actually the transaction happening in practice because they are not getting salaries like employees, correct? So it is that they are depending on their profits. But profits will come only at the end of the year. So they can't wait till the end of the year for their household expenses. So every year some amount will be, every month the some amount will be taken. So they will fix household expenses. I think every month requires 5,000 or 6,000. That will be taken from the business, correct? And it could be every month middle or every month beginning or every month. So in that case, how to calculate interest every month beginning? You will calculate interest for 6.5 months. How many months? Every month middle. Every month end. What is that actually? It is average period. It is nothing but the average period. It is like this. Suppose you are drawing rupees 5,000 on every month beginning. Suppose you draw on January 1. On that January 1 drawings, how many months interest to be computed? On January 1 you draw, how many months interest you should compute? 12 months. February 1 you draw, how many months interest? 11 months. Understood? And March 1? 10 months. For separate drawings only you are supposed to calculate interest, not on total drawings, correct? Please respond. And for the separate 5,000 rupees, for the first 5,000, 12 months interest. Next 5,000? Like that you should be computing till for 1 month, correct? Now, you are actually taking the average of these totals. So you are going to calculate interest for 12 months, 11 months, 10 months, 9 months, 8 months, 7 months and all. Take the average period. Average period is nothing but 6.5 months. So how you got 6.5, you should be knowing. Are you following? What is 6.5? Na? It's average interest period, which is 1 plus 2 plus 3 till 12, which is 1 plus 2 plus 3 till 12 is 12 into 13 by 2, 78. 78 by 12, which is 6.5 months. Understood? If it is every month middle means, then January 15 you draw, it will be for 11.5 months. 10.5 months. Like that it will be 0.5 months. Respond. And the total of this will be 72. The total of this will be 72 by 12, it is 6 months. Understood? Every month end means it is, suppose January 1 you draw, 11 months, 10 months, 9 months, 8 months, like that it will go. Correct? The total will be 66. 66 by 12, 5.5. Are you following? Like that only, it is not a formula and all, it is just that average period. So it will be for 6.5 months? 6 months, 5.5 months. I hope you understand that. Everybody, so every month beginning you draw? So total drawings into, then it is not 5,000, total drawings into rate into 6.5 by 12. Are you following? So total drawings into rate into 6 by 12. Total drawings into rate into 5.5 by 12. Understood? Usually interest to be computed from what date to what date? General concept. Date of drawing to the end of the year. Are you following? For the shortcut only we are applying like this as 6.5 months, 6 months and 5.5 months. Are you following this? Actually for 5,000 you are drawing for 12 months now. 12 times I should calculate interest. Are you following? So, but we can work out an average period basis. Shall we? Everybody. So, these are the things that you should be knowing. Now, let us solve one problem involving P&L appropriation account and partners capital account. And with that, I am just stopping the introduction. I am going to a special transaction like admission, retirement and death of the partner. Shall we? Let us take one problem, please.
A, B, C, D, and E are partners. Sharing profits and losses in the ratio I'm turning the page. A draws rupees 7,500 every month beginning. B draws rupees 9,000 at the mid of each month. And C draws rupees 10,000 at the end of each month. Can I? D has made following drawings. interest on capital will be provided at 10% per annum and interest on drawings will be charged at 8% per annum. E was guaranteed. A minimum profit of 60,000 by 1 and 2. E was guaranteed a minimum profit of ₹60,000 by A&C. Net profit for the year 13-14 net profit for the year 13-14 is rupees 1,000,000. Prepare profit and loss appropriation account and partners capital account. Prepare profit and loss appropriation account and partners capital account based on number 1, fixed capital system. Number 2, fluctuating capital system. So refreshing all these issues into the basics, CPD stuff is what we would like to try. See, it's the appearance only, it is as if it is 100 marks, 3 hours question and all. It is just 10 minutes question. Really 10 minutes question. No, for everybody. So please, very quickly, prepare P&L appropriation account and partners capital account. First, focus on P&L appropriation account. Please, quickly try. Interest on partners capital, 8 lakhs into 10%. For partner B, 5 lakhs into 10%. 5 dana. For partner C, 5 lakhs. Now please listen. For partner A, 12,000 into 12. For partner B, commission, we know there are 4 quarters. We know 2 half year are there. See, these are all simple, straightforward computation. And still, so many varieties of answers. Okay. Now proceeding. Interest on drawings for partner A. Total drawings being 90,000 into 8% into 3,900. Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Next. Please stop talking. Dear friends, please stop talking. Then. Into 5,4,000. Partner D has not made on a fixed interval, not fixed amount also. We'll compute individually from the date of drawing to the end of the year. The first drawing happened on 31st July. How much amount? So 25,000 into 8% for 8 months. Is that clear? In fact, for all the drawings, we should calculate from the date of drawing to the end of the year. Now, from every month end, every month middle, every month beginning, if you take individually also, you will be getting 6.5 months only, average period. Understood? Thereby, we use shortcut. Here, we can use product method. So, or directly we can try the interest because we have got only 3 drawings. So, respective amount. So, this 25,000 to 8% is into 8 by 12. Okay. 35,000 into 5 by 12. Drawing was made on November 1, November, December, Jan, Feb, March. Not December ending. It is April to March. 5 months. Now listen. Please understand. We have learned a lot of silent features. In this, provision wise silent feature we know, some accounting silent features you should be knowing. When the date of drawing is not given, then if the date of drawing is given, it has to be calculated from the date of drawing to the end of the year. When the date of drawing is not given, which means it implies it has been drawn during the mid of the year. And you should calculate interest for 6 months only. This is a silent provision of accounting. If the date of drawing is not given, we are just waiting for the appropriate time to discuss that. If the date of additional capital not given, also for 6 months. But opening capital always for 12 months.
Are you following us? So, but drawings they have not given. So to discuss all combinations of interest only we are doing this. Correct? Every month beginning, middle, end, irregular drawings and date not given. All combinations we are discussing through this question. Understood? So what is the point I am conveying? If the date of drawings not given, then interest shall be computed for 6 months. If the rate is not given, then no interest. Then you should not say 6%. Are you following? If rate is not given, which means interest is not given in the agreement, no interest. But rate given, date not given? 6 months. It will be computed for 6 months. Could you appreciate that? So thereby, it is 1,20,000 into 6/12. Maybe the difference for various answers could be this only. So it is 20,453. Now what is the balancing figure? 10 lakh plus 20,453 minus these amounts. 2,60,453 I would like to distribute in the profit sharing ratio. 5:4:3:1:2. Not 2:1, 1:2. So 2,60,453 into 5/15. Can you use calculator? 5/15. In this amount, 5/15. 86. 8. 5/15. Now I won't apply guarantee now. First let me distribute. Suppose each share is more than 60,000. Then I will give that amount only. No guarantee concept. ANC need not suffer any loss. Understood? Suppose each normal share itself is more than 60,000. E will get that higher amount. It is not always 60. It's not compulsorily 60. It can be either 60 or more than that. Only thing is it can't be less than that. Could you appreciate that? So first I distribute in the ratio 5:4:3:1:2. So 4/15. 6,9,454. 5,209,1. Approximation also you make correctly na 1.1 sir. Okay. 17,364. 360. 3.5. Upper 4. And this is I hope you correctly apply. It is 1/15. Next 2/15. 34. 7. Righta. Now listen. Please listen. Kindly please listen. It has been conveyed that E should be getting 60,000. E should get 60,000. Correct? There is a shortfall in E. There is a shortfall in E. 25,273 is a shortfall. First, finding out the regular share, then find out the deficit. To make it to the minimum profit. Are you following this? Yes, sir. Everybody? This to be normally given by all the partners. If nothing is mentioned, simply given. E was guaranteed. Minimum 60. Which means it has to be given by all the partners in their profit sharing ratio. Are you following? But in this problem, it is specifically guaranteed by ANC only. So ANC only has to bear this blunt. Understood? So ANC will give this compensation in their profit sharing ratio. Understood? Which is what ratio? 5:3. So on 25:273, I hope everybody following.
Yes,
sir. On 25:273, you should apply 5/8 and 3/8.
$15,796
reduction. Correct?
$710,022.
Everybody? Then, how much for C? For B, it is 69454. We are getting the revised. Correct? Now, 9, 7, 42, and this is same 17,364 together. Why 1 rupee extra here? Which is 90? 90 va? Then how come 1 rupee extra? $17,363, yeah. And for this one, 0.6. Okay, inga just one, D give good. Then okay, 50 paise. So this is how we execute this guarantee. Everybody? Very good, sir. Wonderful. Very, very good. Name? Shubham. Shubham has wonderfully made this application. Very good, sir. Wonderful. If you have any doubt, please do raise. With this, we are just putting an into, no, capital account is there. Okay, we'll prepare partner's capital account. Please prepare the fluctuating capital, if not fixed. Just fluctuating capital. Prepare the fluctuating capital. Thank you.
stop talking. My balance brought down 8 lakhs, 5 lakhs, 5 lakhs. Okay. Then we have various forms of profits by interest. Interest on capital, $80,000, $50,000, $40,000, $30,000 by salaries, 1,44,000, 1,56,000. By commission, BND, BND, by share of profit. Everybody?
Yes, sir.
2 drawings. 19,000. Everybody? Next 2. Interest on drawings. 3,900. Okay. 4,344. 2 balance carry down. 6,4,7,1. அப்புறம் முட்டை போடு. 5142 364 330. அப்பா இட்ஸ் ஓகே ஓகே. பை பேலன்ஸ் 64. சூப்பர். Fix the capital system at your place, you can try, right? This alone will come in the capital account, all other item will come in the current account. First item, 8 lakhs, 5 lakhs, 4 lakhs, 3 lakhs will come in the capital account. Understood? All other items will come in the current account. Everybody? So that is how we'll be preparing fix the capital system. Introduction to partnership over. We'll be going to the special transactions. In special transactions, we'll be discussing again some basics alone, goodwill treatment, revaluation issues, all these things, right?